Welcome, you're watching the India Development Debate. I'm Tamanna Inamdar. The use of e-cigarettes or vaping, as it's popularly known, has long been pushed as a healthier alternative to smoking. The rationale has been that since vaping doesn't burn and use tobacco, it is a better alternative. This is now banned in India, and violations of the ban are punishable by law. In fact, the maximum punishment can go up to 3 years. The decision taken by the cabinet today and announced by Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman is based on some experiences in the US and a fear that vaping is now being seen as cool and could influence the youth.
Reports say that actually many people are no longer using it as a weaning step away from cigarette smoking. They do a bit of cigarette, they also do a bit of e-cigarette. If they are already smokers of cigarettes, there are some who are probably getting into the habit because it seems cool. More than 400 brands, and even more important, none of which is manufactured yet in India, but even more important, they come in over 150 flavors, chocolate, strawberry, mint, and anything else. So it's become very cool to try it, to use it.
So now, while there's no public health justification for vaping or using e-cigarettes, some questions have been raised after the ban. First, is there any hard research that shows e-cigarettes are unhealthier than regular cigarettes? If the concern is public health, and that is a valid concern, why no ban on gutkha or cigarettes or other harmful substances which are widely available? And while some things may be bad for our health and we should use our discretion to not consume these, should the government play nanny and punish us for bad habits? To speak on all this and more, I'm joined now by Karuna Nandi, constitutional and media lawyer, Samrat Chowdhery, director at Association of Vapers India. I found out today that there is an association like this. Welcome, Samrat, to the show. Dr. Sajila Maini, President of the Tobacco Control Foundation. Welcome to all of you, and thank you for speaking with us today. Samrat, I'm going to start by asking your reaction, and I'm going to give you the counter. No, you can't argue that vaping is good for you. Perhaps it's a good thing that it's been banned before it turns into a very popular choice and an epidemic, as it's being called.
You see, vaping is a replacement. In our country, we have 110 million smokers. If they're going to take away something which can wean them off it, or at least substitute that habit with something less harmful, then obviously it's a good thing.
Okay, so are you happy with the fact that vaping has been banned?
Of course not. As I said, 110 or 11 crore smokers in this country now don't have access to safer alternatives. How can that be good?
Karuna, how do you weigh in what we've been seeing so far? We know that there was a report by the Indian Medical Council, which the government has leaned upon to show that, vaping potentially is harmful in the United States. There's a debate on it right now. It's believed that it can cause lung infections. Do you think there's a justification for this ban and the punishment that goes with it, between 1 year and 3 years for violations?
At the moment it's a cabinet note, but I think that before they pass an ordinance or pass or make a bill, that a number of factors need to be looked into. Firstly, that while vaping being available in lots of flavors like strawberry, like the minister mentioned, and in the US it was also bubblegum and cotton candy, right? And the point here is that the reason that manufacturers use such flavors is to make it sort of popular with children and teenagers. And in fact, I think New York or Michigan, New York banned it yesterday, banned a number of flavors yesterday except tobacco and menthol. And I think New York or Michigan are looking into increasing the age at which you can buy such things from 18 to 21. So I think that it can become a gateway into heavier smoking, but also vaping in and of itself is not the healthiest thing in the world, right? As Samrat correctly pointed out, it's less harmful than smoking because it has nicotine, but it doesn't have tar, doesn't have other harmful ingredients. So I suppose if the labeling is correct, if the labeling is a bit like cigarette packets, if you make sure that only adults can buy it, if you make sure that those who want to quit smoking, so that it can come down as a downward sort of transition as opposed to a gateway drug. It's nicotine, I suppose, a drug, as opposed to a gateway drug into smoking, then that would be a positive thing. But we need to know how it's working. We need to know precisely the curbs that need to be placed. And I agree with you that the sort of criminal imposition seems a bit knee-jerk and hasty. And so I think more research has to be done on this, firstly. But secondly also, I think we don't have, and I think this is widely known, we don't have adequate controls on gutkha, on the gutkha industry, on the pan masala industry.
Yeah.
And a large number of mouth cancer and other deaths happened because of this. And also cigarette manufacturers, we saw the shares of Godfrey Phillips and other tobacco companies benefit from this announcement. So the question then gets raised, what are you doing to curb smoking? Are you doing enough to curb smoking, or is the cigarette lobby too strong at the moment?
Yeah, that's interesting. Just yesterday, in fact, the Bharatiya Kisan Union pushed for a ban on vaping, saying that this is impacting farmers who grow tobacco. And it was well known, it was in the works. But, you know, that is an interesting perspective to it as well. I want to come to you, Dr. Sajila, and, you know, ask you where you stand on this debate.
I think farmers have been promoted as a lobby by the tobacco industry. I think it's they're trying to make it about farmers as opposed to about large corporates making lots of money.
Possibly. There's no way to know, but you know, we do.
One is just more sympathetic to farmers.
But we do know that this.
No, there
this
are ways
request
to know.
Was. We do know that this request was put out. Okay, no, one minute. Let me come to Dr. Sajila. One minute. Samrat, I'll come to you. Let me come to Dr. Sajila and then, you know, let's get initial opening comments and then we'll open up the debate. Yes, Dr. Sajila, where do you stand on this? Because the data out there is murky. We do know that there are 9 lakh deaths a year because of tobacco usage in India. And there have been calls for bans, but it hasn't been banned. It's a source of revenue, and also people have to fix their own bad habits. I don't know if a government should come in and tell people how to live, even if they choose to live badly.
The government should come in, ma'am. First of all, I need to congratulate the government. This is a very healthy step that they have taken. One, because I've heard the previous speaker speaking, it is not a safer alternative for the harm reduction thing. I am a quit smoking expert. I have handled more than 20,000 smokers and tobacco chewers. I haven't used e-cigarette as a model because it is not a safer alternative for making people quit smoking. One. Second, we have healthier options. Now, people said they don't have alternatives for making people quit smoking. We have healthier options. We can make people quit smoking. I am doing it every day, from morning till evening. I am doing it and doing the stuff. First of all, let me tell you, it's not a harm reduction strategy. It started as a harm reduction model, but today it is becoming an epidemic. It's becoming an epidemic. I see young children from very good schools now for them smoking is an old-fashioned thing which old-fashioned people do and uncles do. For them the latest fad, the latest sensation is e-cigarette vaping. I see people having jewels. They think it's a pride position with them. And see the tobacco has been there since 17th 18th centuries. The revolution came with a cigarette in the 19th century, and then with tobacco. Definitely I do agree something needs to be done for the cigarette thing and for the tobacco thing, but we need to start somewhere. It is becoming an epidemic. Young children as young as 7th class, 8th class, 9th class, I see every day. They don't start with cigarette.
I'd and like come to back address to this
thing. They start with their thing. Because they say, earlier I thought people are going, people earlier I was under the impression that this is a, people use it as a replacement model.
Yeah.
No.
No, you have some model. Responses people coming in, Dr. Sajila. But I just want to ask you that these youngsters you're speaking about, and definitely it's concerning if young children are using vapes. We know that young children start smoking cigarettes as well. But these young children, what demographic are you talking about? What percentage of India are you talking about? You know, the fact is you're talking about good schools,
ma'am, it's not
in
about
urban
the percentage
areas,
thing.
I assume.
It's about the latest sensation. Ma'am, one thing, and one more thing, ma'am. I want to add on one more important thing. People say this is lesser harmful than a cigarette. I nobody can understand what an e-cigarette understands, because I've been handling e-cigarettes day in and day out. Yeah, the nicotine content in an e-cigarette is one joule pod is a pod that is a joule is an e-cigarette. Yeah, joule pod contains more than 20 cigarettes. Yeah, and in a cigarette, what happens in a cigarette when you smoke, 80-85% of the cigarette gets waste, only 15% is consumed. In this joule pod, you consume the entire thing.
Are you saying cigarettes are healthier than
vaping? Who is smoking cigarettes?
Are you saying cigarettes are healthier than vaping?
I can
less harmful.
I would not say cigarettes are healthier than vaping.
Are you saying it's less harmful?
Both have equal harm.
Okay,
harmful
response is coming.
I have seen cardiovascular impacts having because of
vaping. Don't have equal harm. I've got the National Health Service recommending
cigarettes. Dr. Sajila, let's listen in. Everyone's views coming in. Karuna Nandi wants to respond to you, and then I'll come to someone. Yes, Karuna.
Now, I don't deal with cigarettes every day. What I am looking at here, though, is the National Health Service, which is the public health service, the government health service in the United Kingdom, saying that, and they say here that e-cigarettes aren't completely risk-free, but experts estimate that vaping is at least 95% less harmful than smoking cigarettes. That vapor contains some potentially harmful chemicals also found in tobacco.
One by one. Let her finish.
So I think the point here is that when you have the NHS recommending it as a way to quit smoking.
One by one. One by one. Let Karuna finish. Yes.
You should have got one smoker and one...
Ma'am, I will come to you. One by one. It's best so people can hear what you're saying. Karuna, just finish.
So I think, ma'am, the point is that we can't, okay, so here's the thing. The NHS here is recommending it as something that you can use to quit smoking. It is admittedly way more harmful than cigarettes. So I think the question that gets asked then is that why are you banning this as opposed to, in toto, as opposed to banning cigarettes? I think a better tailored ban was that if you say that, look, you can't use the bubblegum flavors and you can't use the other flavors, that you can use the tobacco flavor, for example, so that people who want to quit, children are not attracted, but the people who want to quit can still use it, firstly. Secondly, I would say that... we need to apply our minds very specifically to sort of looking at something that is not necessarily a total ban, because otherwise there's no way in which you can justify the existence of cigarettes.
Hmm. Okay, before I come to Dr. Sajila, I want Samrat to come.
Ma'am, one thing, let me just come on one point.
Okay, Dr. Sajila, please come in.
Just one point, ma'am. We need a complete ban on cigarettes also. I didn't say cigarettes are good. I didn't say tobacco is good. We can move step by step. But this is a very welcome step. We can move from the vape thing to the cigarette thing and to the tobacco thing also.
Tobacco ban doesn't look like it's happening anytime soon. We've already shown you, the Bharatiya Kisan Union asking for farmers, tobacco farmers, that they will be harmed. There are revenue implications. And then the broader implication is that a lot of things are bad for health. Here, just to qualify, I'm not backing smoking, tobacco, vaping or any kind of bad habits, but a lot of things are bad for health. Trans fat is really bad for health. Bad lifestyles are bad. Will you ban? Will you tell people how to live their lives? Is my question. Samrat, I want you to come in. Yes.
I'll start with the farmers' question. You know, the claim that they have made is that this protein is not made in India. Well, that couldn't be further from truth. India is the largest producer of liquid nicotine in the world. And Gujarat is where this manufacturing is done. So that claim is outright a lie and suggests that this is basically a lobby behind it. Now coming to the question of, is it safer than cigarettes? Of course they are safer than cigarettes. There's enough research. Well, if it wasn't, then why would 68 countries, and this is all the advanced nations of the world, right from EU, Canada, New Zealand, regulate its use? And not just that. In these countries, what we are seeing is that there is phenomenal decline in smoking. Now, UK, which is the most pro-vaping nation in the world, has recorded the lowest ever smoking rate. Now, that also throws out of the window this argument that cigarettes are vaping is leading people to come on to smoke. Of course not. If that was the case, then why would there be record lows in smoking? And that's true also with US. It's recorded lowest ever smoking rate in all population groups.
Okay. In fact, Sajila,
people are shifting from cigarettes.
You actually yes. made that point, yes, as well in your opening. Please don't call me ma'am, but you am Tamanna. But you actually made that point in your opening comments, where you said that young kids now think only old uncles smoke, and I'm paraphrasing what you said. So they'd rather go to vapes. So effectively, you yourself have made the point that vapes are replacing cigarettes. Vapes are replacing cigarettes. So the whole what gateway theory kind of falls flat, doesn't it?
Vapes are
One by one.
Let me just finish my point.
Yeah.
Cigarettes are a century old, yeah. More than 100 years, yeah. So the researches have started. Vape is a very new phenomenon. To have an impact on the body, it requires say 5 to 10 years for the impact and the researches to actually come. And believe me, once the researches have started coming, and once the researches would come, it will be not a safer option, not anywhere safer. It also has carcinogens. But I am not here advocating that smoking is going down.
Let's talk about facts at this point. I want to see something is happening.
And very importantly,
one very important thing should happen.
The hookah should also go.
E-hookah
should also go, because hookah is also a latest trend in the youngsters.
Okay, so the problem is the problem with everything that's trendy?
Let me speak,
Dr. Sajila, please. I request you, let's speak calmly. Hypertension is also very bad for health, just on a lighter side. But let's speak calmly. I'm saying, is the problem with things that are cool and trendy?
I've never used e-cigarette as a strategy for making people quit.
No, okay. Is the problem with things which are cool and trendy?
Let's talk about
the problem with things which statistically are proven to harm the people of this country? In that list, I want to put, the terrible levels of pollution in our top cities, where people who don't even have a choice have to suffer, and their lungs have to suffer. Yeah. They don't even have bad habits. So when you're making public health policy, Samrat, I'm coming to you. Just hear my question, yeah. Baba. I'm coming to you. When you're making public health policy as a government, what should you be focusing on? What should be your priority? That's my question. Yes, Samrat.
Let's look at what are the options smokers have to quit. There's the government approved NRT, the nicotine gums, which by the way also have nicotine, which are advertised on TV, which you can buy on Amazon. But nicotine itself was the big evil. Yeah. Then why is it being advertised on TV? So that's NRT. But NRTs also don't work. They have a success rate of just 7%. The other option is that, you quit cold turkey and you on your willpower, that has a success rate of 5%. So smokers don't have options. What we need to do is increase the number of options smokers have to quit smoking. Because it is smoking that is killing 8 million people every year. It is smoking that's killing over a million Indians every year. It is smoking which is causing a loss, economic loss.
Even vape will kill, sir. Tomorrow vape will also kill people.
By taking away options from
people. Vape is a recent phenomenon. It will also kill more people than the
smoking. It is your presumption that vaping will be more harmful tomorrow. But then there's no scientific evidence which is showing that.
It's not your presumption, sir. It's not a presumption. It's not a presumption. You're working with a company that's a e-cigarette company. That's why you're saying, sir.
No, I'm not working with any.
Let us be very clear, sir. Let us be very clear. Anything is bad.
No, we are a consumer world.
Okay. I'm the basic.
One second. You want 111 crore people in this, smokers in this country.
One second. Smoking is bad. Vaping is definitely not healthy.
Don't dare talk about the harm reduction stuff.
Gutka is worse.
One minute.
I'm asking a different question. 1 minute. Samrat and Sajila, please calm down. I'm telling you, tension is the biggest killer. And you can't even ban that. But anyway, so let's calm down. Let's have a calm conversation. Karuna, Nandi, let me come to you. I want to make the basic point, because it's the decision today is not just about whether vaping is bad or cigarettes are bad or which is worse and what the data says. It is about decisions a government takes, a policy decision a government takes in the name of public health, which is a government's job. In that sense, what should be the list of priority? And I come back to the fact that our cities are so polluted right now that small children, before they even discover cool flavors, if that is a fear, are exposed to high levels of pollution that they have no escape from, and there's no sin involved in. There's just no choice. So I'm talking about priorities of public health, Karuna.
Absolutely.
get people to say,
I think
you
that
know what,
this is an extremely important point that you're making because when a baby is born, whether it's Delhi or Bombay or Surat or another city, the top 10 most polluted cities in the world contain a large number of Indian cities. The vast majority are Indian cities, Gurgaon, Delhi, you know, all these places. So, yes, I think that is something that is a national emergency. And it's not being treated as a national emergency. There are sort of disputes between the Delhi government and the Punjab government as to who's going to pay for rotavators, whether the Punjab farmers are going to use particular sort of these rotavators in order to take out the stubble instead of burning the stubble, right, for example. And I think the central government needs to take proper responsibility for this and act fast. Now, this is not to say that there's no need, I think, to intervene in the vaping industry. I think there is. So, for example, you know, when you look at how the tobacco industry started to flourish, they used camel, you know, they used a friendly animal, a cartoon characterish mascot in order to sell it to children, and they knew exactly what they were doing. So, I don't think that it's a non-issue. And I think that, you know, a lot of the things that the finance minister was saying were sensible. But I also think that when we bans and the way that it was announced, it sounded overbroad. It sounded like more research needs to be done before the ordinance is properly tailored. And I very much think that the tobacco industry should be looked at. Governments, when they are looking at public health, intervene all the time. Whether it is a ban or whether it's a nudge or whether it's a tax is something that is also, as you quite rightly point out, to some extent a civil liberties issue. You know, should I be allowed to smoke myself to death or should I not? And so I think that, or should it be more expensive for me to do so? Children definitely should not be allowed to do so, right?
Yeah.
So I think to that extent, yes, let's get rid of the other flavors, no problem with that. But to the extent that it is being used as a substitute, a far less harmful substitute than cigarettes, you know, have the proper warnings, leave the tobacco flavors there for people who are trying to quit smoking.
What about that point, Dr. Sajila? And you know, you've been vehemently saying that you have never asked anyone who wanted to quit smoking to use vaping. You've been working in this, and of course, I put a lot of store by the experience that you've had. But anecdotally, and a lot of people who are listening to this program will bear witness to this, many people who have tried to quit or are trying to quit do use vapes as an option, as an alternative. And as of today, there is no mass, you know, real credible study which says that this is a bad idea or how much harm this can cause. You're right, there may be a study in the future, we do not know. Can you start banning something without knowing what its possible harms could be in the future? Where they would talk about mobile phone causing radiation. Till there are no studies out and we don't know for sure. We don't know if you should use that or ban that either. So in that context, don't you think we need more data?
I don't think we have enough data. We have enough data for the, yes, for the vaping thing, we don't have enough data because it's a recent phenomenon. Yeah, this is a recent thing that has come up. But definitely, I am not advocating whether cigarette is bad or, I would say there has to be a complete ban. And one very important thing, people are saying that yes, all the panelists are saying banning. It's only banning that will work. Education and other things will not work. It's only banning. This is actually hampering the young minds. It's, see the design that they have made. It's like a USB drive. Yeah, and the nicotine in this is highly concentrated. I would actually suggest the next time when you do a program, you'll find my things very you'll think that I should not go into the hyper stuff. Yeah, but you should keep, as a panelist, you should keep one person who is into vaping and one person who is into smoking in this panel, and he'll tell you. And one person who has had both the stuff, he'll tell you what is more harmful. Actually, it's an orderless stuff. You don't have to, and you don't know when you get hooked into it. I have seen people, young children children stealing for the nicotine pods and stuff. So it's a, yeah. The and for the nicotine replacement therapy, very importantly, yes, I do use NRT, but NRT is not used for a long-term process. Anything that is used for a smoking cessation thing is it has to be used for a specific period, say 15 days, 1 month, 2 months, and then we have to wean the whole thing. But with vaping, one, the people don't go and switch over the brand, they'll again go back to their own brand, the brand that they are into, or yeah. If they switch over to vaping, then they don't leave vaping. You're getting, they get hooked to it.
Okay, yeah. I'll take that point.
One very important point. One more thing I would... Yeah.
Yeah, one sec. Let me take that point. I mean, I'm not going to go around asking people...
nicotine gums.
Yeah, right? I'm not going to ask people if they vape or smoke or they try both and what their experience is. I'm not going to do that.
People get addicted. Yes, but Samrat...
No, I didn't use that as a because see no, no, one sec, Dr. Sajila, let me take your people, point forward, please, ma'am. Please,
harm reduction. Yeah. But people use it by themselves.
Yes, please. Yeah. I will request you to pause there. I'm taking your point forward. Let me get someone else's view in, and I want to come to Samrat on an important point that she made. That gum or the patch or other such treatments are temporary and they need to be slowly reduced. Vaping, from the little that we know so far and anecdotally what you see, becomes a complete replacement. So it doesn't get you off. It just replaces, and because you think it's healthier, you might actually end up doing more harm.
Well, see, let's look at how NRTs work. First of all, there's also dual use with NRT. No one picks up a chewing gum or nicotine gum and stops smoking. Have we called for a ban on NRTs because there is dual use of NRTs? Point number one. Point number two is that, okay, yes, NRTs are used to quit, and it's for a very small number of people. It is 7% of, 100 people try, 93% would fail using an NRT. So, secondly, it's not a successful treatment. But what happens is also, if you look at 1 year on, after people use NRT, the relapse rate is 96%.
Okay.
Which means, so what vaping does is actually it keeps people off smoking over a long term. And
people also do both.
Long term.
People also do both. You're right. People use patch also and smoke.
It's a weaning of phase. It's a weaning of phase.
Okay. I'm out of time, so I'm going to wrap here. And I'm going to just reiterate, at the end of the day, we're not here to back smoking, vaping, gutkha, or any bad habits. Don't do any of them. But should you be fined and jailed if you're vaping? Is there enough research to back the ban on vaping? Should the government act as a nanny state? And if vaping is so bad, why allow cigarettes? A lot of crucial questions coming in from this important cabinet decision today. I want to thank all of you for joining me on Debate 1. We'll take a very short break. When we come back, we're talking about our good old public sector companies. Is it time to pull the plug? Even as we decide what to do with Air India, let's take a look at our top drainers who we keep backing. Is there any excuse left to keep supporting ailing PSUs who have long run their expiry date? That big debate coming up next.